There's been a major gas leak near Vishakhapatnam of the kind that we haven't seen in many years now. And that ground report is what I want to show you right on the top of NewsTrack tonight.
People dropping like ninepins, many gasping for breath. Children collapsing right in front of their elders. Vishakhapatnam woke up to the sheer horror on Thursday. No sirens, no alarm bells. A gas leak at the LG Polymers factory in the coastal city of Andhra Pradesh caught its citizens unaware on Thursday. Styrene, a toxic gas, enveloped the entire neighborhood around 2:30 a.m. Defenseless and clueless, citizens didn't know what was happening to them for hours. The result, many are dead, many more critical, fighting for their lives in city hospitals. What you see on your screens is scary. What we have edited out, scarier.
You can see there are lots of people deployed here. The cops are deployed here to control the people. So this is where exactly in the morning where people were picked up, were falling down, and the cops and the DRF teams immediately rushed to the spot to rescue.
Help came late. Citizens were left to fend for themselves. People rushed for medical help in available vehicles. The healthcare facilities are overwhelmed as thousands have been exposed to the gas.
Like a Bhopal gas tragedy, one of the biggest gas tragedy happened in Vishakhapatnam. Non-flammable gases like this pentane and ethylene oxide and benzene dioxide, these gases were blown out.
While the gas may not result in many fatalities, long-term exposure could affect the central nervous system and may even lead to cancer.
Some of these patients will require to be intubated and put on a ventilator. Many will just require oxygen therapy, and we have to monitor for their oxygen, respiratory rate, and their CNS depression.
An investigation is underway to ascertain the exact cause of the gas leak. The gas leaked from a plant that was unattended due to the lockdown. Initial assessment points to malfunction in a valve. With Anusha Pupala, Bureau Report, India Today.
For a sense of what's happening at Ground Zero at this moment, I'm joined by the Director General of the National Disaster Response Force, Satyanarayan Pradhan. Mr. Pradhan, your boys are in charge of ensuring that we're able to ensure that there is no spread of the leaked gas and that damage can be contained. Can you at the outset give us a sense of what's happening at Ground Zero? Is there still a toxic gas which can do damage? Has the situation been contained, sir?
I would say the situation is almost contained. And as we discuss this, expert team of NDRF, CBRN experts, along with some scientists from Nagpur, are on their way to Vishakhapatnam. They should be reaching any time in the night. And they are also carrying the chemicals from Daman, which are also on board that same flight, which will be used to neutralize whatever chances of any further damage or leakage is there, although there is hardly any. But the situation on ground is near normal, is in my assessment, from the report that I've got just 15 minutes ago. And I can tell you and the citizens of the country that the NDRF will be there for the time that it is required by the local administration and the state government, and it is going to camp in that area, in that village, in that factory, in fact, and it is going to be there till everything is back to absolute normal.
So now the biggest concern for me, and it should be for everyone who's watching as well, is that this particular plant was shut for 40 days, as a result of which the chemicals which would have otherwise gone into the system were just lying around, and it's when an attempt was being made to restart the plant and preparations were being made for that this leak happened. So what, sir, are the lessons you think every industry needs to learn, especially those dealing with dangerous toxic chemicals, so that what happened in Vizag doesn't get repeated, because large part of industrial activity for the past 40 days has been shut down. As these plants start, how do we ensure what happened doesn't get repeated?
Well, I think the first thing is due diligence at the right from the beginning. If you want to restart a plant, I think there are two back-to-back incidents that have happened. One in Vizag, of course, and there is a smaller scale incident in a paper pulp factory in Raigarh in Chhattisgarh. Although there is no casualty yet, but some of them are serious. So obviously, in any plant that is opened after a gap, and which relies on chemicals as one of the major raw materials, I think the factory owners must really take care and have due diligence, get the experts on board before they restart the factory. And it is probably a better idea that you don't rely only on your resident engineers or the resident workers, but actually take care of somebody as an external expert, because he would know exactly what to do. And that if you don't do that, I think the net result is actually against the factory owners themselves and the factory being able to start. Now this factory will be not able to start for a longer time. So I think the net effect, even if you don't even if you take an expert on board, and if there is extra cost involved also, it is better and wiser to involve an external expert and ensure that everything is fine before you restart.
This plant makes polystyrene, an expandable polystyrene. What can you tell us about these kind of plastics, the hazards that these can potentially cause, and how this compares with other leaks that have happened in India and internationally?
Well, unlike the Bhopal gas situation, which was near poisonous or poisonous category, this is a toxic gas. The category is toxic gas, and it does have its deleterious effects, but it will happen only when the ingestion is of a very high level and the proximity is of also very high. And the deaths that have occurred, I would assume that they had ingested or inhaled a very high quantity that has compromised their system and the body and the internal organs, and that is why they have succumbed. Otherwise, majority of the patients suffer from irritation of the throat, irritation of the skin, and some minimal damage to the respiratory system. So I think to come back to the issue of chemicals, wherever chemicals are used, whether they are toxic or near poisonous, I think there has to be a lot of due diligence. And there are guidelines by the NDMA, there are guidelines by the Ministry of Environment and all. But I think it is time that it should be really taken cognizance of very strongly.
Okay, Satya Narayan Pradhan, Director General of the National Disaster Response Force. We hope that your boys are able to get the situation completely under control. And your point about ensuring that this doesn't happen elsewhere in other plants that are idling is very, very crucial. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us. I want to welcome also Gautam Reddy. M. Gautam Reddy is the Minister for Industries, Commerce, IT in the government of Andhra Pradesh. This has also become a political slanging match. The opposition is accusing the government of not having made adequate preparations to enable industry to reopen. I'll ask Mr. Reddy that question. But before that, I want to show you a report that we put together using some satellite images, which gives you a sense of where this LG plant was, what all was around it, and the horror as it unfolded. Take a look at this report.
Distressing images from the ground. But pictures from up in the skies, analyzed by India Today, show how close the residential neighborhoods are to the LG Polymers chemical plant in Visakhapatnam. From the suspected point of gas leak in the factory, the nearest colony is barely 250 meters away in the west. This neighborhood is densely populated, housing a post office, eateries, and places of worship. In the east, the nearest neighborhood is half a kilometer away. The LG Polymers plant is built over 70,000 square meters with a perimeter of about 1 kilometer. Local authorities have mapped the vulnerable areas beyond the nearest neighborhoods.
इवैक्यूएशन एक रणनीति का बहुत अहम हिस्सा होता है, क्योंकि जो गैस का स्प्रेड होता है वो एयर से होता है और वो कई किलोमीटर तक जाता है। इसलिए ज़रूरी था कि आसपास के जो मोहल्ले और गांव हैं उनसे इवैक्यूएशन किया जाए। वो बदस्तूर किया गया और लोगों को हॉस्पिटल ले लिया गया, क्योंकि हॉस्पिटल में उनका जो प्राथमिक उपचार है या फिर अन्य स्पेशलाइज उपचार जैसी ज़रूरत है वो हो पाए।
Investigations will determine the exact location of the leak in the plant, but pictures from the ground matched with satellite images indicate the gas might have escaped from the factory's northwest corner. Villages in 5-kilometer radius of the chemical plant have been evacuated, but the incident has severely strained Visakhapatnam's civic infrastructure, already struggling with COVID-19. With Ankit Kumar, Bureau Report, India Today.
Andhra Pradesh's Minister for Commerce, Industry and Information Technology, M. Gautam Reddy, now joins us live on this broadcast. Mr. Reddy, your government is being accused of not having made adequate groundwork, setting guidelines to ensure that a plant which had been idling for 40 days doesn't open in such a calamitous fashion. How do you respond to the criticism of the Jagan government not having done enough to ensure that there'd be no disaster?
To start off with, whatever that the accusations that have come about our laxity on this process is totally untrue. To make the points clear, I would like to start off with saying that this plant was under no notice to restart. It was under the regular lockdown maintenance period that was happening. And if you really understand, the personnel that were available on the site were hardly skeletal staff who were maintaining the plant during the lockdown procedures. Now, post-COVID, May 3rd, the Ministry of Home Affairs had come out with a circular saying that factories in rural areas have to be started and restarted, and natural permissions were to be accorded and things like that. But said this, if there were in particular hazardous chemicals or companies which were categorized as red category, we've issued out protocols and guidelines for the restart processes. I mean, if you really look at it post-liberalization, ever since the so-called license raj was been cut off, we have gone in the industry as a whole, we have gone more on self-governance and self-policing. And if you really understand, and if you look at the chemical fraternity that we have spoken to, a minimum maintenance should always be in place when any factory which is handling such hazardous chemicals. Now, if you were to start off with, let me start off this by saying this. One of the tanks that was containing a raw material ingredient in form of a liquid by way of styrene monomer, it got converted itself into vapors because of the proper temperatures not being held within the storage facilities. And some vapors had escaped through the chimneys. And the first reaction that immediately on knowing this, I think the civil administration very efficiently were able to evacuate the people within the vicinity of the plant. Although the affected area was around 1 kilometer, we immediately evacuated people beyond 3 kilometers. And the first thing that we brought on task was that we neutralized the compound, that liquid component that was there in its harmful effect, in harmful form. We injected inhibitors by way of this PTBC, and we brought in that harmful liquid compound was brought down to a harmless compound.
What are you doing now, Mr. Reddy, to ensure that what happened in Vizag with this one LG plant doesn't happen in other places in your state as these plants that have been lying shut for 40 days are reopened? Okay, I want to show you the kind of politics that's playing itself out in Andhra Pradesh as a result of this gas leak. Take a look.
People gagging, gasping, and frothing at the mouth. A faulty valve in a tank storing styrene burst, leading to a toxic gas leak at this, the LG Polymers plant in Visakhapatnam. No alarm went off, warning the people living in close proximity about the lethal leak at 2:30 a.m. Andhra Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy, who visited the victims in hospital, said the company will have to compensate the affected.
కానీ చనిపోయిన ప్రతి కుటుంబానికి 1 crore rupees డిక్లేర్ అయితే ఖచ్చితంగా చేస్తాము. హాస్పిటలైజ్ అయి ఎవరైతే 2-3 రోజుల పాటు కనీసం హాస్పిటల్లో ఉండవలసిన పరిస్థితి ఎవరికైతే ఉంటుందో వాళ్ళందరికీ కూడా 1 lakh rupees వాళ్ళందరికీ కూడా కాంపెన్సేషన్ ఇవ్వడం కూడా జరుగుతుంది.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi chaired an emergency meeting on the gas leak. He also offered full help to Chief Minister Reddy. A preliminary probe indicates that the lack of upkeep of the tank storing styrene during the ongoing lockdown may have played a big role. Documents show the gas plant was operating without clearance as per the provisions of the Environment Impact Assessment Notification of 2006, but had consent from the State Pollution Control Board. LG Chemicals, which last year sought a nod to expand the plant, promised to treat the gas hit and a thorough probe. It is unclear why the company didn't do proper maintenance for tanks storing the toxic gas. Both opposition TDP and BJP, meanwhile, have questioned the lapses. While the TDP wanted the factory shut, the BJP has demanded punishment to the culprits.
I now demand a proper inquiry, and also I demand the resignation of the Industries Minister of Andhra Pradesh.
It is the thing which happened due to the government officials. They haven't followed due procedures as far as the pollution control assessment is concerned. How they had continuing that unit around the houses is the million-dollar question.
The Human Rights Panel has written to both centre and state asking why the plant violated basic safety norms.
The gas leak has also started a political war in Andhra Pradesh. Now opposition BJP and TDP is trending gun on ruling YSR Congress party and asking why this particular factory, which doesn't fall under essential services, was allowed to operate. That too very close to all these residential areas. With camera person Damodar, Ashish in Hyderabad for India Today.
Now, I think the critical message to my mind is ensure that you've got all preparations in place before restarting these factories that have been lying shut for 40 days. That is most crucial. That's the national big picture message.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.